Hey there, I'm Albert Bosazan, and I'm here today to help you get rid of the randomness in your Stable Diffusion results. Text prompting is cool and all, but you almost never get the image that you actually want. Now, if you've been using Stable Diffusion for a little longer and maybe watched some of my other videos, you'll immediately think, yeah, but ControlNet is a thing, right? You don't just have a text prompt, you can also give it images to control the result. Yes. The problem with that is you need to give it images. Where do you get these images? You can use stock photo sites, you can even take photos of yourself posing in a way you want your character to pose, but in my opinion, that's still quite limited, because you'll never be able to get a complex fantasy or science fiction scene fully represented like that, right? No, but you can if you use something like Blender. So I'm here to teach you some fundamentals of the free software Blender that you can then use to create depth control nets for your AI images. Much like these. Here are some examples I've created in the past for different projects, and here's what we'll be creating today together. I know Blender looks pretty complicated if you've ever seen it before, but don't worry. You only need to understand a few simple features that I'll show you, and then you'll be able to fully control the composition of your images, camera angles, focal lengths, and even poses of your characters if you really want to dive in deeply. Without further ado, let's get started on that. We're going to need two things to do this. Most importantly, your Stable Diffusion UI. I recommend Forge because it's faster, but Auto 1111 works just the same, and that's where I started, so it's absolutely good. The link to download that is in the description, but you can also use online services that support these UIs, so you don't necessarily need your own powerful GPU to do this. If you haven't seen this UI before, definitely right now go and check out my Stable Diffusion Basics tutorial first, and then come back. Otherwise, you're going to be frustrated. I'm not going to be explaining all the features you can see here. Next, of course, you need to download Blender, where you'll build your scene in 3D. You can get it on blender.org and install as you would any other software. And we're also going to need the free Blender Kit add-on, because that's going to give us access to thousands of free objects that we can place in our scene without having to build them all ourselves from scratch. Don't unzip the thing you downloaded. Open Blender, go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, Install from Disk, and then select the zip you downloaded here. And it's that easy, you've installed Blender Kit. So more about how to use that later on. While we're still in the Blender preferences, I recommend doing three more adjustments, just trust me on this one. In navigation, make sure the checkbox is ticked at Orbit Around Selection, so we can always get focused on the object we're working with. And also in navigation, check auto perspective and depth. That's a little trick to help us with zooming around. Just in my opinion, makes it easier. And one final step, close the preferences and up here on the right in the shading menu, hit backface culling under the option. That's going to let us look into our scene. You'll see what that means in just a second. Now let's get comfortable inside the Blender viewport, which is this main area here where we already have a cube. I strongly recommend using a mouse, not a trackpad, to navigate the viewport. We can select this cube with a normal left click, and by holding your click wheel and moving the mouse, you can rotate around it. If you hold Shift while doing that, you can also move around laterally. By scrolling, you can zoom in and out. And if you ever want to recenter your object, so move your camera back to the middle of your object, hit the period on your numpad and it's going to take you right back to it. So let's keep this cube and turn it into a room. By hitting Tab, you enter Edit Mode, which you can also do in this menu up here. Just click there. And this is where you can adjust the shape of objects or meshes. So first, we're going to want to select the floor and bring it up to the real floor level in our viewport so we don't have headache later. And we need to change the select mode for that, because right now we can only select so-called vertices, so these points, and we want the whole floor. So up here, we change the select mode to face, then just orbit down here and click on the floor. You can see that our cursor is already at the right spot in the middle, so the little circle you see here. And with Shift-S, you can pick selection to cursor, and your floor is going to pop right up to the cursor. Now, immediately you're going to notice, of course, we can't actually see inside this room yet. And that's because the so-called normals of the walls are flipped. So to explain that simply, each face of a 3D object has a direction it's facing. So there's only ever one direction. and we're seeing the outside right now. If you want to go up here and understand that better, you can click here and actually display the direction of the normals. If you click, you can see they're all facing out, which is why they're blue. And if you hit A and select everything, and then click Mesh, Normals, Flip, you see they're all red now, and we can look inside. So if we remove that overlay and hit Tab again to get into Object Mode, you can see we're inside the room. Now we're going to want to go into the so-called N panel. So if you can't see it, hit N and it's going to pop up. And otherwise, you see these little tabs here. We're going to want to go to Item, and you have the dimensions of your room here. Right now, it's 2 by 2 by 1 meter, which is a very small room. So just by clicking into here and adjusting the numbers, you can make it 4 by 5 by 2 meters. So just enter those numbers, hit Enter. And now to make that permanent, to apply that because the scale is off, you can hit Control A and Scale. Congratulations, that was already the hardest part of this. So now we can actually add the objects to the scene we're building here. Up here you will see Blender Kit, which you installed earlier. So let's put in a window. In here you can search window. Now some of these are paid, but under filter you can just click here and select free first. And now we can pick the first free window. It downloads here. But of course, we're going to want it by the wall. So let's use the cursor again. Tab into the room model, select the wall, and hit Shift S, cursor to selection. Now you can tab back into object mode, select the window over here in the outliner, so you make sure you get all the parts of the window, and Shift S, selection to cursor. And now it's on the wall. Of course, now it's rotated wrong, so keep it selected, hit R for rotate, Z for the Z axis, the up and down axis that we want to rotate on, and enter 90 for 90 degrees. Perfect. Now it's rotated correctly. It's a big window, so you can move it around a little bit. By hitting G and Z, you can move it up and down the axis, and to scale and change the size, you hit S and rescale with the mouse. Hit Enter to finish. So once it's where you want it, let's add a couch. To actually download it straight to where we want it, you can also put the cursor on the floor. Let's do that. And now we download the couch. And it's going to pop right into the middle of this. Now to position this one exactly where you want it, I'll teach you another trick. You can actually exclude axes. So if you hit G to move it, and then Shift Z, you can move it along just the X and Y axes, so the floor. Now I'm going to let you pick how you want to decorate the rest of your room. And now finally, it's time to position the camera. You can see here that there's already one in the scene, but it's kind of just somewhere where it doesn't make any sense. So using your mouse, just position yourself in the viewport reasonably for a camera. And now click over here in View, Align Active Camera to View. And now you've brought the camera to where you are. So if you want, you can just select the camera, and using G and R and the tools I've shown you, you can move it around however you want. Down here in the camera settings, you can also even adjust the focal length if you want. So I recommend using numbers that are popular with real cameras, so 24 millimeters, 35, or 50 millimeters, for example. And now it's time to actually render this image and get it into Stable Diffusion. So the great thing is we don't need good quality at all because we only need the black and white depth information. So to get that depth information, go to Render Layers and hit Z under Passes Data. And you can actually uncheck this combined layer because you don't need that information. Then go up here to the render settings and you can turn these samples way down. You need only one to get the basics. And also turn off shadows. You don't need this. Next, you can go to the compositing tab up here and you only need to add two nodes. You can add a node with Shift A. The first one you need is something called normalize. Because when you get the depth information, it's going to give you depth information from the start of the camera to the furthest possible point in your scene, which you don't need. You only need the furthest possible point to be part of your actual scene, so the end of the room. And with normalize, it does that. So the furthest point is going to be pure white, and the closest point is going to be pure black. Now, if you've worked with ControlNet before, you immediately know that sounds a little wrong, right? Black is the furthest point, not the closest. So the second node you need inverts that. It's just called invert. And now we plug these together. It goes from Z to normalize to invert and to image. And now it's ready to render. You just go up to this menu and hit render, render image, and it should pop up immediately. If you don't get a good result, no worries. It might take some time getting used to Blender and all of its features. So I've also included some links for you to additional Blender tutorials that might help you in the description. You can save your result up here, and now let's bring it into ControlNet. And here we are in Forge. Again, if you've never seen this interface before, check out my basics tutorial where I cover what all of these boxes and little numbers mean. From here, you can use the image you created in Blender just like you would with any other ControlNet. So scroll down here. There's one key difference. Normally, with depth, you would use this preprocessor here that estimates the depth info in your image. So if it's a photograph, it creates that depth information. But we already have pure depth information, so make sure this is set to none, because otherwise you're going to get some really weird fails. So make sure that's off. Then scroll up, pick the settings you want, write your prompt, and hit generate. And here you go. There's the room we created, almost exactly how we built it, removing any uncertainty about how your AI image will be composed. You can use any style. I've done a couple different prompts here. Of course, this composition is nothing great because I didn't have like a bigger project around it, but you can use this method for anything, including short films. If you want to have shots, multiple shots in the same location, this is an excellent method to get that going, because you'll have much more consistency than if you just tried to text prompt everything. So it's a super powerful method. And that was it already. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I much appreciate likes, comments, and subscriptions. If you want to see anything in a future video, feel free to comment. Now, I know many of you have been wondering where I've been. I only make videos very rarely now, and that's because I've been quite busy with my day job at Storybook Studios, where we make AI films and shows. So if you're curious about that, we actually just released our new AI-powered kids series, Space Vets, and my team and I have been giving several long interviews about that over at Civitai and Curious Refuge. So if you're curious about that, links are down below in the description. I would be happy if you stopped by and checked out that work there. I'm Albert Bosazon, and as always, I hope you have fun with Stable Diffusion.